What I always find useful is to compare and contrast different algorithms so that we can point out what's the same and what's different. We're going to do that next. Let's again look at updating a vector by doing a matrix vector multiplication. Here are the two algorithms that we came up with. The one on the left walks through the matrix by rows. The one on the right marches through the matrix by columns. Now, what do we notice? Well, we notice that the update that happens to elements of Y is identical. We notice that in both cases we have a doubly nested loop. But what's important is that in the one case, we march down the rows of matrix A first, and then across the columns of A, while in the second algorithm, we walk across the columns of A first, and then down the rows. So the only way in which these algorithms differ is that the loop order is exchanged. If you ever see this in a compiler course, they will call that loop exchange. We can also compare how we express the matrix vector multiplication with the flame notation versus the loop. Now, what's going on here? This outer loop is exactly the loop that marches matrix A down the rows. And notice that this inner loop is completely hidden. Where is it? It's inside of this dot product right here. So only one loop is exposed. The other part is hidden in another linear algebra operation, in this case, a vector operation, dot product. Similarly, you can look at the other algorithm, and what you notice is that the outer loop goes across the columns. Well, here the algorithm exposes one column at a time. And you notice on the left here that Y is being updated with an XB operation where you take a multiple of the current column and add it to Y. That hides completely the operations in this innermost loop. And we can also put the two algorithms in flame notation next to each other. And I guess the thing you really notice is that in one algorithm you expose rows, in the other algorithm you expose columns. One algorithm performs dot products, the other algorithm performs XB operations. So in summary, I guess all we really have to say about this is that different ways of algorithms yield different insights, and therefore it's worth looking at it in various ways.